Each time Spotify recommends the next song of a band you have never heard about, it uses a recommendation algorithm based on older users' interactions with the song. This type of algorithm is called collaborative filtering. Unlike content-based recommendations, collaborative filtering shines when the object's semantics are loosely or unrelated to the user's preferences. This adaptability is what makes it so fascinating. Movie, music, or book recommendations are good examples of those use cases. Indeed, we rarely choose which book to read based purely on the plot twists. The traditional way to build a collaborative filtering engine is to train some kind of model that converts the sparse matrix of user-to-item relations into a compressed, dense representation of user and item vectors. Some of the most commonly referenced algorithms to do that are SVD, singular value decomposition, factorization machines, etc. However, the model training approach may require significant resource investments. Model training necessitates data, regular retraining, and a mature infrastructure. There is a way to build collaborative filtering without any model training. Obtain interpretable recommendations and have a scalable system with a technique based on similarity search. Let's take a look at how it works with an example. Imagine we want to build a movie recommendation system and have many reviews from different users. We can represent those reviews in the sparse matrix, and if we have a list of movies we like and dislike, we can search for the top 10 users, maybe 20, with the most similar tastes to ours. By doing this, we can discover the most liked movies that we haven't seen yet by looking at those users' review lists. So here we will use a simple yet powerful resource in Qdrant, sparse vectors, to implement the similarity search. So we start by importing the necessary libraries and loading our datasets. Here we have three main CSV files, user ratings, movie titles, and IMDb IDs, respectively. We load the CSV files and preprocess the data. This includes converting IDs to appropriate format, normalizing ratings, and merging data frames to get movie titles. Here we have an extra function to fetch movie posters from the IMDb API to give a finishing touch. Then we initialize the Qdrant client and create a new collection to store our data. We convert the user ratings to sparse vectors and include movie ID in the payload. Okay, now we can try to recommend something for ourselves. So we have some movies with ratings. We will perform a search in Qdrant to get the top recommendations, I mean the most similar ones. Here we can filter the results to order by score and sort them to get the top 5 movies. Finally, let's display the top 5 recommended movies along with their posters and titles. So, as you can see, building an interesting movie recommendation system without intensive model training is possible with Qdrant and sparse vectors. Maybe in other videos we can experiment more with this combination. I hope you liked it. The links are in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.